almost everything that's around us, everything that we do every day, is underpinned by science. It allows us to understand, you know, what's important about a reef, for example, why we need to keep that reef healthy, because it helps to keep the waters clean, it helps to process and sink carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, and just helps us to understand the connections and why we really need to look after our planet. Ashmore Reef is part of the marine parks networks in Australian waters. Ashmore is really exciting because it's one of the few that has a true coral reef growing in it. And you can kind of think of that as a biodiversity hotspot.
So when we think of coral reefs, we're familiar with that shallow area. Mesophotic reefs are where you move out of the normal sunlight zone. So you go a bit further down the slope, there's less and less sunlight, and the kinds of species change. But it's not yet in the very deep sea. So it's sort of that middle region. This kind of research is quite important because mesophotic reefs differ around the world. And since we're just starting to understand them well and explore them better, the more we can do that in different parts of the world, the more valuable the whole picture together is.
It's been a very long steam, so we've been so keen to get here on site. Now we're here, it's like it never happened. It's in the water, yay! Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Karen Miller from the Australian Institute of Marine Science, and we're here on board the RV Falkor, and we've just started our very first dive here on Ashmore Reef with the ROV Sebastian.
At this stage of the expedition, we're really thrilled with what we've found so far. So we've been able to obtain some really significant samples, but also made some really interesting observations as well. So Ashmore Reef was initially famous for having a huge diversity of sea snakes, but around the year 2000, all of that diversity disappeared. So we weren't really expecting to see many at all, but we thought we'd keep our eyes open. Amazingly, already, we've seen about two or three species, including the short-nosed sea snake, which is kind of a rediscovery of that population, the first time in over 20 years. So really thrilled with that so far, and we're only just at the beginning.
The most exciting part, which was 100 metres depth, where we started to see some really beautiful big gorgonian fans, big orange fans, much bigger sponges. And some of the sponges were amazing because they were like an ecosystem on their own. They had so many other things living and growing on them, and fishes swimming around them, and that was the bit that was probably the most exciting. So it teaches us that we don't know very much at all. And so I guess for the next few days, we're just going to keep our mind open about what we might find on Ashmore Reef in the mesophotic zone, and it's just going to be a really exciting discovery.